Here's your reminder that fat phobia is rooted in racism. The main thing to understand is that for the last 300-ish years, white folks have been marketing fatness as a black trait. And this is regardless of whether or not black people individually were actually fat.
To be thin and to be white was to be original, like one of the original settlers, and it was to be godlier and it was to be better. The first European settlers who came to the US were basically Western European Protestants. They held certain values that included like abstemiousness, you know, you were supposed to deprive yourself, and they valued being slender as a sign of godliness. And I think that it's really interesting the way it intersects with weight issues. And it's not coincidental. People from Eastern Europe, they were people from Africa, they were people with different body types, and they were people with darker skin. And so there was this whole sense of otherness and othering that happened. I think misogyny is also a big part of this conversation around diet culture and racism. You can really see diet culture as a support of white supremacy, because it's really based around this idea that of social categorization and comparison. It's based on this idea that there is a state to which, you know, we aspire. There's a state that is naturally better than, and everything else is worse. When you only look at images of thin white women, that becomes the norm.
As a fat woman, a lot of time, guys will come up to my friends and I and will flirt with my thinner friends. And that's fine. But the way that they interact with me tells me every single thing I need to know about them. So many times, they won't even look me in the eye.
A concept that we always come bang up against is the idea of hegemony, which is a very fancy academic word that basically just means the way that we internalize the social norms. If you can keep people down, and through hegemonic ideals, is like the beauty of that is you don't even have to do anything. You just get it started, and we do it to ourselves. We oppress ourselves. Then wow, that is a great way to keep power centered in the white patriarchy. So one of the great paradoxes from a certain perspective of diet culture is that, you know, a lot of people engage in it to because they think it will make them healthier, and it actually does make us less healthy in a variety of ways. There's a lot of psychological suffering, but that also impacts our physical health, because we are also learning now that living in a constant state of shame and, you know, fear and being discriminated against is actually really bad for your health on every level. It raises your cortisol levels in your body, it raises your adrenaline levels, and those things actually are associated with worse health. The amazing thing about that kind of internalizing is you don't need someone standing over you going, you must be thin, you must lose weight, you must be white, you must whatever. You do it to yourself. It's like participating in your own oppression.